How long have you guys, I know you guys are into the game. Do you know anything about the A1 phase, if I said that?
A little bit. No. I don't know what that means. Going right over my head.
Perfect.
Blank slate. Blank slate for that.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Great.
You guys action, right?
Okay, so if you take the entire phase of human courtship from the time you make initial eye contact with a woman all the way to getting her in bed somewhere around here, going through a relationship, going through the breakup, the divorce, and never seeing her again, we're actually going to... I want you to imagine you're on the top of a skyscraper kind of looking down at this timeline and, you know, pull out your magnifying glass, and we're going to zoom in today for like the next 2 hours on the first 2 to 3 minutes. So the reason that's so important, first impressions are everything, right? So.
Yep.
Right. Are here, right? Yep. Cheers.
So today we're going to, I'm going to give you guys, some openers, pre-scripted routines that are designed to convey certain personality traits, certain alpha traits, to get women attracted to you, to get them engaged in the conversation, ways to come in under the radar to get through her bitch shield. You guys ever encountered the bitch shield? You know?
I'm not a bitch.
It's like, go ahead, Hold on.
You two are bystanders.
No more drinking.
Targets.
I didn't know what it was called.
Okay, we can go to the next slide. This is my contact information for you guys. And you don't have any pins or paper, so use your download it into your head.
You got your card.
I got cards.
Cool. Yeah, I got your card.
We can go to the next slide. Alright, so I want to talk about the social mask. Essentially, what we're doing in this game is we're putting on a mask. People wear these their whole lives. I know that you guys, on your own, when you're in your room by yourself, you probably act a little different than you do, say, when you're with your parents in church or when you're with your buddies at a football game, right? So what we're doing is we fashioned a special mask for you to put on. You can kind of hide behind the material that you're going to show so that when you come in the set, you'll be able to demonstrate confidence, dominance, power, charisma to that girl without appearing too needy.
Yeah.
It's like the star right now. It's like the star of attention.
It's bright. Dude. It's really bright.
Need a taco?
That sounds really good. No, I can't. I skipped the gym tonight.
So I'm going to read this for you guys since it's like micro. The social mask, a false persona or facade used to garner attention and feel socially accepted. We all have different sides to our personality. We may be one person with our lover, another with our neighbor. We wear a different mask at church than we do with our buddies at a football game. We act, think, and behave differently with different people in different social situations in order to effectively meet the demands of different kinds of challenges and opportunities. In our daily life, we encounter hundreds, if not thousands, of people depending on the current activity we're undertaking, and to all of them, we project a different image of ourselves, to our friends, our family, our neighbors, our teachers, and to others. We do this in hopes of being socially accepted by our peers, enough so that we're willing to change ourselves completely for this acceptance. In terms, we project a different persona, one that in hopes others will take a liking to, in order for us to be included as part of the group. We say things we normally wouldn't, we act in a different manner, and our choices and preferences often change to suit those of others. Everyone wears a mask for everything, in friendships, job interviews, even in relationships with wives, husbands, and other family members. Every social situation of your life, you've probably been wearing this mask. Most people do not understand that they have the power to either control the mask or let the mask control them. So in this game, through the attraction, comfort, and seduction phases, you must know when and how to use the mask, and when to take it off, and when to quickly put it back on if you need it. Learning to use a mask is like learning to ride a bike with training wheels. As you progress in this game, you will, in time, learn to lose the training wheels, take off the mask, and begin to open with natural game, and express your identity to women and to the world. Does that make sense?
A little bit.
So the idea behind this program today is I'm going to give you certain openers or routines. We call them canned routines, in the can, back pocket openers, that you can use for those 2 to 3 seconds to build the attraction. And then when it's time, when you get in the comfort phase, you're trying to build trust, comfort, connection, you sit down with her, you can take the mask off, let down your guard, be yourself, allow her to do the same, and then you can actually build a real connection. Slide. So, the opening phase, A1. To begin a conversation with a person or a group of people. The word open, as it is used in the community, stems from mystery, who borrowed the term from magicians to use it to refer to a starting performance. In the parlance of a magician, opening a set. Opening is one of the first steps in pickup beyond making eye contact. Opening is usually accomplished by an opener, which is a piece of conversation the PUA uses to get into set. It can be as simple as saying hi, or reciting a memorized set of canned routines.
I'll get it.
Dominoes.
In pickup, as in life, first impressions are important, so it is a good idea to set the proper frame when first opening a set or a target. What up?
Hey, how's it
going?
Adam.
Long time, brother.
I'm trusting your presentation.
Come on in. There's not much chair left.
Here,
oh,
I got one.
Thanks.
I was going right to the target. Thank you. Thank you, Michelle.
You're welcome.
It's life.
It's not a Swiss class.
So an opener. Openers are what PUAs use to get conversation started with the woman they're interested in. PUA openers can range from a simple hello to elaborate stories that have been crafted to get their target interested in them. An opener is simply used to begin the conversation. A lot of guys, they get this concept and they learn an opener, and most of these openers are scripted so that they're a few paragraphs long, maybe even a few minutes long. The idea is to just use it to spark the conversation, and then you want to snip and stack to your next routine. If you stay on the opener too long, it becomes boring. Have you guys ever been like the, do you ever walk up to a girl and you use the opener like, do you guys believe in drunk I love yous? And this opener is like 5 minutes long. And
drunk. It's a comedy routine.
Yeah. So when you come in,
no, but I'd like to learn that one.
Yeah, it's good and it'll work and they'll get engaged. But when you do the whole opener, they're gonna lose interest. So you want to cut it at one point and then stack your next routine. All right, next slide. Types of openers. I'm gonna give you a definition on each one of these. Canned opener, we're going to discuss a few of those today. I'm going to give you a lot of direct and indirect. A canned opener, like I said before, is a routine that's already memorized, a scripted pattern. You can even keep it on a cheat sheet in your back pocket if you want. So when you're going into the venue, you ever hear that, you feel that moment? There's this perfect, beautiful girl right here. And your buddy's just managed to help you get the balls enough to push you and just go talk to her. You're like, what am I going to say? What am I going to say? What am I going to say? I got to think of the magic line that's going to get her panties wet and make her lights light up and want to sex me right now. Hi.
You think the same thing.
I like the music in here. Yeah. I like your shoes. So we all have that problem, right? Comes up from time to time. So instead of that, we already have scripted routines that I'm going to give you tonight. So you can have them on your autopilot response, so when you see your target, you can immediately go and, hey, guys, get this, I have a quick question, I gotta get back to my friends. Okay, slide. Oh, no, hold it. I got this is a long slide. Okay, a direct opener. A direct opener is an opener that's instantly telegraphing interest. If I walk up, I'm like, you are smoking hot. Wanna hang out? I'm instantly kind of giving all my cards. Right away, she knows what I want. The game is over. I've already given her the power. Direct will work if she's already attracted to you. Let's say I was up on stage doing karaoke, and she's like, oh, God, this guy's hot. He's doing it. And then I have my my wing come in. Yeah, that's my buddy up there. This guy's awesome. He, you know, owns this club and blah. And now she's already like, look, this guy's hot. So if I actually come up to her at that point and I telegraph some interest, she's going to be responsive. She's probably going to buy me a drink. We're going to do a lot of, I'm going to give you some canned direct ones that'll help you out. Indirect is exactly the opposite. Indirect is when I'm not telegraphing any interest. I'm playing coy, I'm playing hard to get, or I'm acting like I'm just leaving. Or maybe I'm just chatting her up just for shits and giggles. I might come in and I mingle with my friends and I see you guys and I'm like, well, what do you guys think of this? What do you guys think of the 49ers or the Cowboys?
Oh.
I'm not telegraphing any interest, right? But the conversation's starting now. Digital openers. Email. This is where I could go on Plenty of Fish, Match.com, eHarmony, and I can telegraph some kind of interest to the girl, but I'm not actually face-to-face. I get a little box with subject matter, and I get the email line. We're not really going to go into this. The online game is like a whole other topic, but if you guys...
Sorry, you're just...
You're working
on it.
Dude, you're working
on it. Sorry, you're going to go to it. It's done.
Do you got dollar bills?
I was about to say.
Sorry, the next one's not coming off.
So, you guys ever do any online game?
Never.
Yeah.
Not since high school.
A little bit.
A little bit? Have you noticed anything, like any kind of patterns?
So, it's kind of random what I've noticed. It likes one thing that works on one, doesn't work on another, but realistically, when I do it, it's usually just act more cavemanish and just don't care.
A lot of guys like, if you guys ever do any online game, the way you get really good is actually make a female avatar profile and just watch the kind of responses the guys get. You always see subject matter.
Recon.
Hi. Yeah. Box. Wow, you're hot.
Yep.
Now, if she goes on vacation for a week and comes back and checks her email, she'll have 300 of this identical message. She's going to scroll down. She's never even going to see it. So, if you guys want to know some good ones that kind of force them to open, talk to me later about that. Stuff like, instead of hi, you might want to put capital WTF, ?
That's a
good one.
To
make her say, well, what the fuck is this?
Right.
And then you're going to have a completely different kind of script. In fact, usually you use like a lot of time management and online gaming. So there's one message that works really good that I use, and you just copy and paste that into every girl's profile. Okay. Eye coding. Sometimes you don't even have to use any words to start a conversation. I can look at the girl. Now I know if I make eye contact with a girl, she can do four different things. Let's say I look at the girl, if you were me, and you're looking... That was way out of context. Let's say I'm looking at the girl, and she looks up and away. What do you guys think she's saying?
Not interested.
You caught me looking.
Anybody else? It's not that she's saying, I'm not interested. She's saying, I can't be approached at this time. Her boyfriend could be standing next to her. Her shield's up. You haven't built any attraction. It's not saying don't go in. It's not saying it won't happen. But be mindful when you get that. Let's say she looks to the side and then gives you this. What do you think she's saying?
Seeing if anybody else noticed that you're looking at
her. Meet me for a quickie in the bathroom.
Keep her close.
Hate it when that happens.
Insta-fuck. Check it out.
7 minutes.
She's saying, notice me.
Got a big nose.
Notice me.
No, you don't. I'm just saying.
I'm not Jewish. Let's say she looks down, back up.
She
knows the answer.
She'd be in a little coy.
Basically asking a question, asking you to come to her.
Approach me. Mm-hmm. Approach me now. Put your beard down, leave your friends, and come talk to me.
Look at your pants. Yep. Mm-hmm. You're really looking at your pants. Yeah.
You're looking at the pants?
Yeah. It's like, hmm.
Looking for what's in them?
Yep. Or what's not.
Fair enough. Oblique openers. This is where I go into set, and I don't even have to actually talk to... Actually, can you guys come up here?
That's us.
Do you need to go on this one?
Okay,
here.
Not for me.
Put it on the...
Chris, yes.
If you guys could draw a position like here and here.
Position over here. I'm just kidding.
Okay. So let's say Chris is my target here. I don't even have to go up and talk to her directly. And if I did in the set, I'd be completely ignoring friend. But I can go up, open the conversation with our friend, and obliquely demonstrate my value and upload it into her head. When I'm sitting here telling this girl about myself and conveying my personality, she can still hear me. So then, when I do turn and talk to this girl, my value's already uploaded. So now it's not a cold approach, it's a warm approach. She's going to be much more receptive to that. Thanks, guys. Those also work like if you're up on stage, say like karaoke is great, because she can already see you, and if you're kicking ass up there, she's going to want to meet you. Kino. She has no Kino.
Touch.
Kino. Kinesthetic, short for touch. That's any kind of opener. How many did you get?
Cool. One. Go, Chris.
Just one.
Go, Chris. God, like, those things are riding at my ass.
I can Kino on the opener. Hey, what's up? High five. How's your night gone? I already broke a physical barrier in the first second. You ever go... That's not Sean.
No, that's all.
So imagine you guys ever gone on a like an AFC date, taking the girl to dinner,
really,
a movie, and you haven't even like put your arm around her, you haven't even touched her, and you're just like, God, I don't know. And at the end of the night, you're walking her to the door, and it's just like, oh, thanks, I had a good time. And then there's that big awkward moment of, oh, is she going to kiss me? I don't know. Yeah, I had a great time. You guys ever have that?
Never.
Well, if you have...
You break that instantly at the very, very beginning. That's the first thing you do.
As soon as you open, start building Kino. Little taps on the elbow, high fives, fist bumps, maybe a half hug and then push her off you. IOI, calibrate with the IOD. Gesture. Watch if she returns the gesture.
Oh, that's good. I like that one.
Where's the leader?
Or... It's an opener. Opinion opener?
Calm down, girl. Okay.
Have you guys ever done any opinion openers?
G-string.
G-string?
Yeah.
What is an opinion opener?
G-string.
I use the generic one.
Yeah?
Jealous girlfriend one.
Okay, cool. An opinion opener is when I'm going to open a conversation with, hey, guys, I got a quick question. I got to get back to my friends, but I need an opinion on something. Or I need a female opinion, I need a guy's opinion. My little sister thinks men lie more. What do you guys think? Who lies more, men or women? Okay.
That's good. There's no yes or no in it. You force someone to engage in a conversation.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Situational opener?
Who cares?
Hey, how you guys liking this meeting? Situational. I'm in the bar. I have my bar neighbor right here. Talk about the football game. Talk about what are you guys drinking? Something that's going on in the moment. Focus opener? Something she's focusing on. She's in Starbucks and she's reading a book. Dude, is that Anne Rice? Oh my, hold on a second. Boom. And she's engaged. Flopsy is like the focus opener, but it's something you're anticipating that she's about to focus on. Let's imagine you're in Barnes & Noble, and she's about to pick a book off the shelf, and you say, no, you don't want that book. It sucked, I read it. But this one right here, check this out. That was fun. Improvisational, making some off the spot. There's an Asian dude in the group, and he has the... His openers is, booga booga. he just comes up and says something random.
You have to have the look to pull that one out.
He does some weird shit, but it's got a girlfriend now. It works.
Booga booga.
Yeah, that works for you guys.
Hell no.
Any I'll cheesy pickup line, you know, usually teach these.
Well, shit, if you're
going to
be like that.
Cheesy pickup lines. They're a way to open, but they're not necessarily going to work if you actually come up. The way to win with a cheesy pickup line is, one, if she's already attracted to you, it really doesn't matter what you're going to say. But if you want to open with a cheesy pickup line and she's already attracted to you, then you have to do it to the absurd, like super cheesy, like, so, just what I thought, made in heaven.
Oh, God,
but she already likes, yeah, it's terrible, right? And I bet if a guy, if you didn't know the guy, right?
There really is.
I don't have it.
They do work, though.
Yeah.
The cheesy. I still use What's Your Sign.
Come here often.
Time you get off.
What's your sign? And that's all you have to say, and they just start laughing and laughing.
Hell yeah.
I need to get some of those.
Random chains. Opener is like the improvisational kind of same thing, just different lingo. Blowout openers, have you guys ever used those?
Mm-mm.
What is that?
What does that one mean?
Bye, Chris. I'll take your beer. No, I have. How about goodbye?
Hey, could you just, like, blow me out? Just give me your worst rejection. I'm with my friends, we're gonna go pick up some girls, and, I just want you to just warm me up for the night. Just, you know, tell me to fuck off, tell me anything. What's your worst rejection you've ever given a guy?
To give you a rejection?
She can't even do it.
Damn, she's really nice.
No, he's an asshole. Go away, douchebag.
Is that the best?
With a smile.
Is that the best you can do?
A smile and a laugh?
I eat nice girls like you for breakfast. Okay, thank you.
How do you mean meaner?
It throws them off, like a perfect example, so much that it actually starts getting fun.
Do they know what that means, the blowout?
I mean,
she didn't ever kind of tell her a little bit.
I know.
But some girls will. For example, there was a four set. And I was with my wing, and the primary was at the bar getting some drinks. And his target was in the group. So me and the wing rolled in, and we're like, he's like, hey guys, can you blow me out? She's like, what? And we're like, just give us your worst rejection. They look at each other, and they're like, oh, we don't do that. In fact, my friend thought you were kind of cute, and we actually wanted you to talk to us.
No shit, huh?
What? Well, like, well, actually, we're just here with my friend. He's a magician. He's in town staying at my place for the weekend. And then he comes in right at that time. He's like, hey, beer for you, beer for you. We're like, hey, meet these cool girls. They're not weird or anything. Hey, this is blah.
Huh.
And he was gone with the girl. Me and my wing held off the other three for like another half an hour, wherever they went. I don't know, food or something.
Hmm.
Compliment opener. Kind of lame. If you do, like, I like your shoes, right? It gets her the opportunity to say, thanks, I have a boyfriend, and she's gone. But if you say, I noticed myself noticing your necklace, does that have a meaning behind it? No, she can't really say thank you. Again, open-ended question, like you said. Cool, slide. There's more different types of openers, that's what I came up with off the top of my head. Okay. I wish you guys had some paper.
Hello.
You have any paper?
You didn't tell us to bring paper.
I have coloring books.
I have notebooks in my car.
Oh, I have coloring books. I got coloring books.
Yeah, because I was gonna. It's better if you write them down so that you can, reinforce your brain to.
Go get them, please.
I can go get them.
You have pen, paper, your car?
Yeah, I always have some paper.
Oh. Yeah. Do you want to hit stop on the video?
Do you want to go get it?
Yes.
I have a whole bunch of pens.
Yes.
Yeah, run.
Yes.
Can you run to your car?
I have meetings every day.
Yes.
I always bring my notepad for Ryan.
It's good. That way you guys don't have the paper. I'll give you all the answers.
Oh, that's funny.
Okay. Beer break. Ready to go?
Yes.
Okay. Who lies more open? This is like the classic community opener. Now, when you write these down, in set, you don't want to do these verbatim. You want to do them concept for concept. You have to be able to do these on the fly, because she's going to have a different response. You're going to have to calibrate to her behavior, to the way that the her friends are receptive to your opener. But who lies more? Hey guys, who do you think lies more, men or women? Who do you guys think lies more, men or women? Who do you guys think lies more?
Women. We don't have the guts to tell people the truth.
What about you?
Men.
Yeah. That's what I thought. See, I think men lie more, but like women lie bigger. Because men, you ever been with a guy and you're like, where were you last night? And you know he smelled like perfume. He's at the strip club making it rain. And he's like, oh, I was at Chuck's house. Right? But women, they'll look at you and they'll be like, yeah, it's your baby.
I told you that story in secret. I'm just kidding.
See where it hits? See where the laugh comes in? Now I've just demonstrated humor and confidence. Without having to actually tell her, hey, I'm a funny guy. I'm a confident guy. I'm demonstrating that.
We just went down.
Uh-oh.
Did you guys get that one?
Here we
one
go.
Time?
Here we go. Yes.
Cool. Dental floss. Hey, guys. I have an absolutely empirical question. The fate of humanity can depend on your answer. Dental floss. Before or after you brush?
Before.
After.
See,
no, it is
no one
actually
knows the
before.
Answer.
No, it is actually before.
No,
that
was
it.
After. So,
that's what the two said we'll do. One will say before, one will say after. See, no one knows the
my
answer.
My ex is a dentist, it's before.
And stack.
Yeah,
my ex is a dentist. It's actually before because when you're in there, you're getting stuff out. You want to brush it away and wash
well,
it out.
Well, then your mouth wash it away.
That is the second part of it.
Floss.
When you have a target and obstacle, and what the let's say the target says after, this is like the part two of it, you can bag on her because the obstacle will say before. You high-five the obstacle, create a jealousy plot line in the target, and you say, yeah, dude, why would I want to brush it after, dude? Right? You don't have to even take it that far. You can just put dental floss before, after you brush, before, after. See, no one knows the answer. Hey, get this. The other day, you cut and stacked your next routine. Remember I said, like, you're just using the opener to open.
Right.
Spells. This is also, this can be used as an opener if you use it short, or you can use it in set as a routine. Do you guys believe in spells? Or do you guys think spells work? Okay, get this. My buddy, he was dating this girl, but like, I don't know, he wasn't that into her, right? It was something with her smell. I don't know what, you know when people smell is just not right? But anyway, they end up having sex, and the next morning, she went to go fix him breakfast, and he went to get his shoes. He's getting dressed, and he goes under the bed, and he sees this little bag. The best way to describe it is like a little, like, kind of mesh, like, potpourri bag. It had, like, a little note with, like, a scroll. Like, you ever seen the movie Lord of the Rings, and it had, like, that elfish writing? It was weird. But inside there was, like, these bones. Not like, they weren't dirty then. They were clean bones. But he was like, what the fuck is this? So he took it from her, and he calls me up, and he's like, dude, this chick is like, I don't know, come check this out. So we went, and I looked at it, and I was like, I don't know. It looked like something out of World of Warcraft or something like that. But I was thinking, you know, there's this shop that sells candles over in Summerlin. I like to, you know, put a lot of candles in my apartment because, you know, I like the smell and the incense. And I was thinking, this little old lady over there, she probably knows, you know, what this is. So we go over there, and we show it to her, and she just looks at it, and she's like, it's an attraction spell. And she looks at us like we're crazy. I'm thinking, like, we're guys. We don't know that shit. And anyway, so we didn't think anything of it. He put it back under the bed. And this was like a couple months ago. And now, like, every time I see him on Facebook, he's updating his wall of, like, how much he's, like, super in love with her. He can't get her out of his head. So do you think the spell worked, or is it all bullshit?
It's like one of those five-minute openers you were talking about.
Yeah, usually, if when you use it on the open, it's long. But if you wait and use it in set, it hits a lot more. And the weird part about that, the last time I used this was on, like, a hairdresser. And I was sitting there, like, I opened her with, you know, let me get the haircut. And I was like, okay, this is, like, the first time I want to try this routine. And I'm sitting up there, and she's blabbing away. And I was just like, dude, I got a question for you. I need to feel my opinion. Do you think spells work? So I went through the routine. And for the next half an hour, she goes off on this tangent. She's like, yeah, you should know that. I'm a white witch, and blah, blah, blah. And I'm thinking, like, the fuck is a white witch? And this conversation went for, like, another half an hour with her, you know, talking about how she, you know, is into witchcraft and spells, the word spells, and the word energy, and psychology, those are like these magic words you can say in a conversation to a woman to get her, like, oh, what's this? This is different. It's interesting. You guys, can we do that one again three more times? Mm-hmm. Thank God, I hate that one.
Good. I hate that one, too.
Okay.
I hate that one.
Girls and tattoos. Mm. Hey, guys.
I love tattoos. Me, too.
What do you guys think about girls and tattoos?
You all think they're hot.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Only tramp sex.
Mine are on my back, my neck.
It's okay.
I
got mine when I was
I have a slave stamp.
I just don't like the ones up here with like a hook.
I have my slave stamp. It's okay.
Slave.
So you have some?
Yep.
Well, get this. My little sister, she's 19, and she's been dating this guy Steve for like 2 months. She wants to get his name tattooed on her shoulder.
Fuck that.
No, not like this, like down like this, Steve. How do I tell her not to get this tattoo?
Can't.
Oh, stop. That was good.
It's
that
better.
Was good.
Oh, that is a good one.
So your answer would be something like,
you're crazy.
I'm crazy?
No, I'm crazy. She's crazy.
Yeah. Well, that's the thing. If I'm her older brother, and if I tell her not to get it, she's just going to want to get it that much more. But what's up with that? Snip and stack.
That's a good one.
One more time?
No.
Sorry, we're hot.
That one's perfect. That was like one of the first ones you turned me on to.
You're making me so hot.
I know.
Jealous girlfriend. You said you used that one before, right?
Yeah.
Hey, guys. Quick question. My friend's girlfriend found pictures of an ex underneath the bed. She told him to burn them, or she's going to break up with him. What's up with that?
I can't imagine someone told him to burn that.
Say that one again.
My friend's girlfriend found pictures of his ex underneath their bed. She told him to burn them, or she's going to break up with him. What's up with that? Or what do you think about that?
Hide them. Why the hell would you leave them under the bed?
Shit. Jeez. Mm-hmm. I have better.
So you open with that. She's going to give her response. She's either going to say one of two things. She's going to, right away, you're kind of qualifying. You're going to see what kind of girl she is. She's either going to say, like, fuck yeah. My friend did that. My ex had those. I should have told him to burn them. Or she's going to say, I don't know, that's kind of psycho. And then you can proceed to say, yeah, that's what I told him. I told him to leave her. Like, personally, I'm a really sentimental guy. Like, I have all my old yearbooks from high school. Blah. Snip and stack. Cool. Herman. Hey, guys. Would you ever date a guy named Herman?
No.
Okay, get this. My buddy Herman, he's never good with the ladies. A month ago, we decided to change his name to Steve. Getting laid like a fucking rock star now.
It's like the Sherbinator. Herminator.
Yeah. I mean, if I had a girl named Beatrice, I don't know if I could deal with that.
Beatrice. Oh, she's the fat chick you used to date.
Like Betty, too.
You know about that?
Change her name.
I do.
All Natashas are hot.
That's true. All Natashas are hot.
All Natashas are hot.
That is
good.
True.
Isn't
very
it?
True. Gigi's, don't date those.
Yeah. Bertha.
Bertha?
Bertha shouldn't have been a fat chick.
Bertha's a tough one.
Bertha's a fat chick. She's not fat now, she can be fat later.
Wait a minute, I'm looking forward to this next one. I want to see if this is all about.
Herman.
Do you know why you suck? Yes, I do.
I know that.
Do you know why you suck?
Uh-huh.
I have been trying to meet you for 10 minutes, but you, Miss Popular, are surrounded by all these people. I can't even get close to you. You suck. Who are you?
That's pretty strong.
Mm-hmm. Who are you? And she answers, I'm Cindy.
I'm
and you cross your arms. And that's special because?
I think, like,
so wait, I'm trying to pick up on lingo. So it's like you gave her a negative, and then you brought it, then he came back. Boy, you're really like bouncing around there.
Mm-hmm.
Push pull.
Yeah. You know what's the weirdest
push,
one about this?
Push pull.
Like
that was the phrase
I
was looking for.
We were out doing an event called Sargopoly, where I dress up like a Monopoly man, and you know the Monopoly dude has a top hat, and I put weird random openers in it, And the guys would, like, you know, you would put $5 in the thing and draw a challenge from the hat. If you go and reach the hook point and get the number, you get your $5 back. If you get blown out of set, the $5 goes to the, you know, beer money fund. And there was a girl that I had a challenge on, and then I told her what we were doing, and she's like, oh, that's fun, I want to play. She draws the, do you know why you suck? She's like, what do I do with this? I was like, find a guy, go up and say, open the conversation with, do you know why you suck? And she's like, what did I say next? I was like, you figure it out, improv. This guy walks by with this huge, like, cowboy hat, like a sombrero thing, and it's enormous. She turns around and she goes, do you know why you suck? And he's like, why? And she's like, your hat's not big enough.
That's a good one.
And he cracks up, and they actually ended up having dinner that night at a Blue Martini. Random, dude. Do you know why you suck?
It's a good one, is it?
David Bowie, Mick Jagger, it's like the same opener. Hey, guys. Do you guys think Mick Jagger is hot? He's like 80 years old. My little niece has a poster of him on the wall. Like when she wakes up, like a huge wall-sized poster. This is what she wakes up to. She's 7. He's like 70. What do you think about that? Hmm. Like, do girls really think that's hot?
The ones that have daddy issues do.
Alright, direct openers. You guys ever done, we're done with indirect now, so you guys ever done any direct?
And
I bet that was successful.
Wait, what did you say?
Okay, it's an acquired taste.
You gotta come really confident, really ballsy, really dominant, powerful, very congruent with you are, with who you are. So here's a couple stock canned direct openers. First one, absolutely adorable. So you're going to come up to her, hand out, hey, I got to get back to my friends in a second, but I thought you were absolutely, pause, adorable, and I had to come meet you. My name's Ryan. When you do that little pause, she's like, I just thought you were absolutely... She's like, what?
The biggest bitch in the room.
And then you relieve the tension. You bring the tension, release it. Take her number. Take her number. Take her number.
Well, you're really moving fast.
I just thought you were absolutely adorable, or like, absolutely super cute, and I had to come meet you, because... If I didn't, I'd be kicking myself in the ass for the rest of the night. My name's Ryan. Ryan. Handshake. Give her a fist bump. Yeah. Usually what I do with this one is, then I'll say, like, I've really got to get going, but, you know, are you on Facebook? And then I'll, you know, Facebook close, grab the number. Or if she's walking, then you can start walking with her. Snip and stack. You know, what nationality are you? Blah. Whatever. Sexy and beautiful. Remember this from the bad boy one? Mm-hmm. Actually, I need you.
This one. Me?
Bye.
No, I'm gonna swallow this.
Take your time.
In the group. That's a different class. Brian, remember that's my direct.
That's the class I teach.
Remember that's my direct opener.
Oh, I'm sorry. That's
do you remember my direct opener? Do you swap?
Oh, that's right. That's
you guys were busting my balls because I use that as my direct opener. I go up to him and I just go, excuse me, do you swallow?
I like that one.
And
I like
I've got
lines.
More play out of that than probably any other direct.
Hold
because
on,
they're
I
so
pause
surprised.
For a second.
You just ask
girls
them, do
like
they swallow?
Lines. We not,
I
not
go up, if there's at least four of them, I just go up, there's four hotties, I just go up, excuse me, do you swallow? And they're in such shock. They go to town on each other, and they can't believe that I have big enough balls to actually say that in front of four women. But I don't say much.
Or
I just let them
go to
town.
You're taking a survey of how many people swallow.
Excuse me, do you swallow? And that's all. And these guys were busting my balls on it, but I've been using this.
I'm sorry, I'm stealing that.
You should.
We call him Chevron. Hanging out in the.
That's the one you use the absolutely most attractive. Because they wouldn't expect that in a million years.
That's crazy girls.
Is that really direct?
Like
because
wild,
that's kind
yeah.
of...
Hey,
like,
I'm not wild, and I like it.
That's you're
wild.
You like salad.
I mean,
it works
yeah.
for me.
I gotta write that down.
Do you swallow?
The answer is yes.
Target.
R-E-S.
Down, down a little bit.
I know.
It's a long night.
At least my heart is
seriously.
She needs another shot,
I think. She wants too many shots is a problem.
What I need to do.
Let's just imagine that you guys are in set. Here.
Yes.
And you guys are just kind of talking.
Hi, how are you?
No,
I never say that. Oh, we know each other.
Yeah.
Okay.
You guys can come in.
And the Giants play next
week. Oh, you're coming in. You're coming in. I got it.
You guys are just talking.
Blah, blah, blah.
You're going to come in.
Blah, blah,
hand
blah,
on.
Blah.
Not like this. Not grabbing. Turn around. You are so damn sexy and beautiful.
And then that's when I start busting up laughing.
Who are you? What's your name?
I'm Chris.
Now, see how I didn't stop when I said you're sexy and beautiful? Because if I pause there, she's going to say, thanks, I'm with friends. I immediately went in, you're open to the question, who are you? What's your name?
Yeah.
And proceed from there. If there's like a guy in the group, hey, I'm Ryan, what's going on? And then have your wing come in and mini ISO with him. And
can I pause for just one moment and ask you a question?
Who are you?
This.
What?
Who are you? Open-ended question.
Yeah, like, who are you? What's your name?
Kristen. The concept of going up to... I can understand going up to one girl, two girls, group of girls. But going up to a group where there's also guys seems to me like a non-starter.
Guys are just ugly chicks.
Yeah.
That's good. I've never heard that one.
Or you can tell if this girl is not comfortable with talking. Like, maybe they're talking to some guy. They're like, this guy needs to go away, rolling their eyes or something.
So never assume.
Those guys might want to sleep with her, but she might not want to sleep with
them. She's not interested. She's probably like,
I almost prefer when he took me out to the first Friday for the first time, I only hit on chicks that were with guys. When I
really?
He was telling me, go hit on these ones. Because she might be with you, but she doesn't want to sleep with you.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Another version
that seems the biggest wall in my mind. I'm trying to get rid of right now.
Call that a sticking point. So we're going to break through that.
Okay.
If you have approach anxiety, guys are actually easier to approach. Like, stop chatting to a guy, and then you can get attention
through
that. So guys are a lot easier. And then if you're friends with them, then they won't block you later.
Right. Check this one out. Another version of that. If you're spinning around talking to him, you can come in.
No! No!
Wait, do that one again.
Ryan, that's advanced.
Just turn it down.
That's good.
Yeah. I'm just fucking with you. My name's Ryan. What's going on? I thought you were...
Oh, shit.
Okay. Apocalypse opener.
I love that one, dude.
Wait, I gotta kind of take notes on the one. Give me a second to take notes. That was good, Ryan.
Take your time.
I don't know if I could do that.
I can't believe you're doing the apocalypse up here.
He's going to love this one.
Yeah.
Yeah, it sounds like it.
That's actually good.
Fuck
that. I'm
gonna
make
hey, once you get ballsy enough, you should be able to just go in. Start making out.
Do you swallow? That's... Good night, everybody.
Oh, you haven't gotten to the good one yet.
That's good.
Okay.
That's funny.
This one.
That's fun.
This next one is for you. Apocalypse opener. Four lines.
Yeah.
You open. Hey, what's up? How's your night going? What are you doing later? Do you want to come home with me?
That's it.
Hold.
Yeah.
Just hold.
Gotta maintain.
Just back the back out?
1, 2, 3, 4
One more time.
At that point, okay. Hey, what's up?
Pause and let her answer, but...
How's your night going? What are you doing later? Do you want to come home with me? And then hold. In parentheses, hold at the end. Because at that point, she's going to be checking for any kind of incongruence. Like, are you really the man who just came up to me and fucking said that?
All right.
Are you this guy? You can't look away. You can't, like, put your hands in your pockets. You can't...
No hesitation.
You can't rock around,
balls
fidget.
No weakness.
Bam. Balls of fucking platinum.
All she can say is yes or no. It's like
what was 3 and 4? I'm slow.
Hey, what's up? How's your night going?
What are you doing later?
What are you doing later?
Do you want to come home?
Do you want to come home with me?
Now, why? I'm asking why. Why would you choose to use that one?
Why not?
I saw one guy.
The point is
posted.
To do something different.
Right. I don't know how true it is, but this guy said that he was getting a percentage of, like, maybe if you went to a mall and you did this, he's getting about a 15% ratio.
Yes on the fourth question.
Yeah.
Yeah. This
if you do that 10 times, you get 1.5
so
times.
So it could possibly be a number game.
This is great, a blog this guy puts in, and I think it's what you're talking about. I think it was on Pickup.
I think it was Attraction Forums, actually.
Attraction Forums?
Yeah.
And this guy, he uses the line, "Hey, my name's Joe, what's your name?" And she's like, whatever, Colleen, and you're like, "Well, Colleen, now that we're on the same basis, let's go back to my place and fuck."
Yeah.
And that's the line.
Right.
And he, in great detail, does one set after another, in, like, huge detail. He's like, "I approach a 7 on the on the bench at, like, a university, and I use the line, and she laughs." And then, and he comes up with statistics, and he's like, 1 in every 16 said yes.
Right.
You know, 1 in every 20 would hit me, 1 in every...
Yeah. Go back to the...
That wasn't the one
it was the 1 in 16,
like
though.
Yeah.
And that's good. Like, imagine if you're a skateboarder or something. If you don't fall, you're not trying hard enough, right?
Mm-hmm. Right.
So you're not gonna, all
right. Exactly.
Okay. Push it to the limit.
Just for fun, you gotta do it once in a while.
But the key, though, like, when you're doing this direct stuff, you gotta remember this. A lot of guys learn the wrong game. They got dumb. Say there's 2 kinds of girls in the club, or 3 kinds, whatever, but... One is, like, you know, an emotional girl who's looking for a relationship. So when you go in direct with her, she likes that. She likes that response. And then there's a girl that came to the club to fuck. She put on her boots, shaved her legs, shaved her pussy. She smells good. She's looking for a guy who's going to come. You ever go into the bar and start noticing the girl who's sitting on the edge of the bar just sitting there texting by herself. Take her, pull her to the bathroom.
They also say... At the end of the night, when the bar is closing, or whatever, or when the club is closing, like outside, that's a good place to do it.
Yep.
When they've given up, you know.
A lot of times, we're not even going to the club anymore.
We
have
no morale left.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Pick us up, we'll take you home.
Keep us from crying at home alone.
It's us guys that are willing to take you girls home. Okay.
It's like we practice and we train, so we already have a handicap, and then we go find the drunk girl, and it's like, double handicap, we're cheating, I don't know.
Right, that's definitely cheating.
Let's see, any cheesy pickup line, we went over that before, and anything instantaneous telegraphing interest, like you were saying, you know, now that we know each other, let's go fuck. My shoes, hey, let's fuck. It's all direct. Next slide. Okay, so before the open, they can actually pre-open to turn it into a warm approach. Pre-opening a set is meeting them briefly, then ejecting before returning later to begin your normal routine. A pre-open will last 5 to 10 seconds maximum. You will offer the set a piece of value and a takeaway. You will not FTC, you will actually leave. Give your name before leaving. Leave before the hook point is reached. Example, to a hired gun. I walk in, I give a random high five. Hey, what's up? We're talking to, like, a, you know, hot bartender or waitress that you're trying to hit on. You see her instantly. Hey, what's up? Hey, I'm Ryan. I actually got an appointment with the urinal, but can you give me a Henny and Coke and meet me by the bar? So I'm not going to continue with the opener, I just pre-open her, she knows of me, I leave, then I'm going to come back later and actually start to open. Raising the glass, just walking around to random people in the club, hey, cheers, hey, what's going on, how's your night going, cheers. And once you come back later, they're going to be more receptive to talk to you. And also, like, have you guys ever done the cheers routine? It pumps your state rate really quick, because you're talking to so many people so quick, like, you get a lot of endorphins and... adrenaline pumping out.
Confidence
makes it a lot easier.
You can walk into any place and do what you just said, and now you're not a stranger when you come back around the next time. You're that guy. You're the party guy.
Yes.
Oh, shit.
Let's see. Okay. This one, too, like the girl, your target's in a group with a guy. You can walk by the guy, hey, high five, fist bump. Hey, what's up, man? I'm actually looking for my friend. Did you see a tall guy? He came in here. He's like 6'5", wears like a top hat and goggles.
mystery.
Actually, I'm getting texts right now. And, you know, you tell him you're getting texts, and you walk away while you're texting. So the target already saw you. She got a little bit of your personality. Then when you come back in later, you're like, oh, did you find your friend? Yeah, I don't know. Something blah. Hmm. Blah. let's see. You guys seem interesting. I did that one. Okay, say you're at the bar. A lot of times, like, you know, you sit down next to the hot girl, and most guys will sit there.
and wait for something to happen.
She's just on her phone. And if you stall out, when you open later and you're like, so, how's it going? You're demonstrating you have like no balls. But if you immediately sit down at the bar and go, hey, what's up, I'm Ryan, it looks like I'm going to be your bar neighbor tonight, what's going on? Oh, hold on, actually, get a text, go to the bathroom, at least you initiated the chat, so you don't look like a creep. Let's see. Okay, the dynamic changes after a person has met you once. Even if just for a quick second, after your return, it will become a warm approach rather than a cold approach, and both parties will feel more comfortable as there is a sense of already having known each other. You said, that slide?
Well, one other thing that kind of I would say, like, the time I use that the most is in clubs. If you go to a club, you meet people in the line. So you say hi to them in the line. And then when you see them in the club, you say hi to them again. And then if you want to, then after the club night's over, you can hang around, and then the people you met in the club, you can meet again. And they'll be familiar with you. It's not like being blown out, because you haven't really approached them properly, and now they recognize you, they know you, and they want to hang out with you. You know, it just kind of works within the context. Does that make sense? Yeah.
Sure.
It's kind of the same thing. Yeah.
Short setting, this is a little different than not a pre-open. You're actually going to stay in a few minutes this time, and you're not short setting in a set that you're necessarily looking for the target. The target may be on the other side of the room, but if you short set every set in the entire club, you've been building a lot of social proof. So she sees you out of the corner of her peripheral, like, oh, this guy is like knows all these people, he's high-fiving the manager, he's talking to the bartender. You stay in the set a couple minutes, and then... You know, if there was a girl that was in one of those sets, you can also come back in later, like the pre-open. So short setting. The practice of quickly opening up multiple sets in a venue in order to establish social proof. Short setting is a technique that PUAs use in order to build up their social value and get into a social state, rather than focusing on opening just the woman they are interested in. With short setting, the PUA works the entire room, staying in for no more than a few minutes before moving on to the next group of people. Short setting has a number of benefits. First, it helps the PUA to get into the social mode by getting them talking to large numbers of people, similar to warm-up sets. Short setting also has the benefit of building social proof, as the PUA is seen talking to everyone in the venue instead of just hitting on some girls. This raises the social value of the PUA and makes opening subsequent sets easier. Finally, by short setting, the PUA is able to introduce himself to everyone in the room, which allows him to later reopen sets he talked to earlier, and get a warmer reception than if he had just approached them cold. Short setting can be as simple as going around the room giving toasts, high fives, or actually going around introducing oneself to different sets. Whatever method the PUA uses, the idea with short setting is to stay in set for no more than a few minutes and leave the set on a high note whenever possible. Alright, so that was fun. Reopening. The act of re-engaging a set that was previously opened with initial greeting can also be coined as a warm approach. Reopening is one of the keys to creating strong social proof within a venue. The idea of reopening resolves around the fact that the initial open cannot directly lead to sex. As such, the PUA can first engage a new set by simply saying hello. The next time he sees them at the bar, he can say hi again, and the cold approach thus becomes warmer. The more sets that can be reopened, the more social proof the PUA has within the venue. Sometimes a girl is simply too preoccupied within the club environment to go home with you on the first encounter. She has her friends, she has her cell phone, her drinks, she's dancing. As such, reopening her in a way that adds value, or reopening another set of hot babes that make her jealous, may be key to making her feel attraction for you. Approach priming, which is kind of that game that we were playing a second ago. The idea of priming and prepping for an approach in order to set it up for the highest chance of success. Guys get nervous on the approach. As such, the technique of approach priming was invented. It was first explored extensively in gambler stealth attraction techniques. The idea is centered around priming for pre-approaching and setting yourself up for success. Some techniques that warm up the initial approach are being seen talking to another hot girl with an unbreakable opener before her, and then walking away first. Forcing an IOI, or indicator of interest, with a wave or a toast. Eye contact, holding and forcing her to look away to give an IOI. In the case of an IOD, you know not to approach her right now, if this is your first set. Setting yourself up in a positive mood. Group merging, or going, getting another girl to introduce her to you. Approach priming works good if you're really nervous in the beginning. I still approach prime. Do approach priming. Actually, before I go out, I have a whole like kind of meditation ritual. I take a lot of focus factor vitamins, ginseng, ginkgo biloba to get my brain kind of working, so I'm not going to go blank. Red Bull, Monster energy drinks. We're good.
It's actually a new thing that's like that's for AA. I just got like an email about it like a week ago. I don't remember what it is, but I'll have to look forward to send it to you.
Send it.
It's supposed to be like completely rid of like all that stuff. It's like one thing.
Is it cocaine?
Yeah.
Okay, go. Next slide.
Go to the next slide.
Oh, yeah.
I'm
so
thinking like that.
Definition of a warm approach. An approach on a woman with whom the POA is already acquainted or who shows some interest in him. The warm approach is a blanket term used to refer to any approach that is not a cold approach on a complete stranger. Usually this takes place during social circle game, where both the POA and the girl have a mutual friend in common. That commonality is usually enough to break the ice and make starting a conversation and a relationship with her a lot easier than if the POA had just run into her in the street. A warm approach can also be used to refer to when a pickup artist reopens a set that he previously opened and left on a positive note. For example, using the technique of short setting, a pickup artist may very quickly meet and talk to everyone in the venue, even though the POA is only able to give a brief introduction of himself in the time. Just that little bit of a connection is usually enough to make the POA's next approach a warmer one. POAs also use the term warm approach to refer to easy approaches. In this context, a warm approach can mean approaching a girl who is throwing out heavy IOIs, or approaching someone in a situation where the pickup artist is heavily socially proofed. A warm approach in these cases is an easy approach on someone who is at least somewhat interested, rather than approach on a stranger who hasn't shown the slightest bit of interest. A warm approach versus cold approach is approaching and opening a girl or a set that the POA has never met before. Average frustrated chumps and some naturals often argue that cold approaches are not necessary if one has a growing social circle of which he can get girlfriends from. Gambler argues in The Natural Art of Seduction that the cold approach is what gives us ultimate choice to meet a girl who is not part of your life and having the skill set to make her part of your reality. Mystery states, the cold approach pickup. It is a beautiful art form. Ultimately, any successful POA has had his share of cold approaches in order to get where he is today. 3-second rule. You guys know this one?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Nope.
Okay. The 3-second rule is a rule that says you must approach a set within 3 seconds of opening them, or 3 seconds of seeing them, or them seeing you. The 3-second rule is a guideline that many POAs follow to overcome approach anxiety. Hesitating too much before an approach can lead to overthinking and nervousness, and can also creep a set out if they notice you staring at them for too long. Opening a set within 3 seconds allows you to be in the moment more. It doesn't give you enough time to come up with excuses for not approaching the set. We call this analysis paralysis. Even the best POAs have approach anxiety, thus the 3-second rule is the counter for this natural fear from our biological mechanism. We're actually doing the 1-second rule now. You guys heard of that one?
No.
It's just like that one, but it's like 2 seconds shorter. Community humor. Okay, go ahead.
Okay.
Yeah, if you see him, don't even hesitate. Just walk in and blast that set open. Hey, guys, what's up? The more you sit there and you think and you start backward rationalizing, you create, like, as we see in pictures, you'll see, like, across the scroll of your mind, like, so many reasons why it's not going to work out, so many reasons why she's going to, you know, reject you. Oh, my God, she's going to slap you. She's going to throw your drink. And then you just stand there and you freeze, and then she's gone. So just go in. Okay. Oh, thanks. False time constraints. Verbal FTCs. A statement a pickup artist makes when opening a set to communicate that he will not be able to remain long, to reassure them that he will not take up too much of their time. Developed by Style, the FTC helps to keep sets from getting annoyed by the presence of a new stranger. Whenever people meet someone who they don't know, they feel a certain amount of concern about how much time this person is going to take up with them. FTCs have a subtle effect of preemptively dissuading such feelings and also making the presence of the POA more valued, as he may leave at any minute, which creates a feeling of scarcity. FTCs allow the POA enough time to reach the hook point, at which point the group or target will try to get the POA to stay. Here's a couple stock canned FTCs, should I write these down? So before your opener, I gotta get back to my friends real quick, so I only have a minute. But I wanted to ask you guys' opinion on something. I can only stay a second. I'm here with friends. I gotta get back to my friends in a second, but I'm curious about something. You know, I'm in a rush for this meeting, but... Need more time?
Do you want me to go back to that?
Good. Body rocking. That's a non-verbal FTC. A term coined by Mystery to describe the use of physical movement to create the impression that a PUA may leave the set. Body rocking is a non-verbal false time constraint that the PUA can use to convey that he is not too needy and that he may leave the set at any time. An example of body rocking would be to slightly turn away from the set as you were just about to leave, to create a feeling of loss in the target before returning to the interaction. Body rocking should be done smoothly and unconsciously as if as a bait to reach the hook point in the set or make the girl give an IOI and chase after the PUA. Chris. Need you. So what I mean by that, I've only got a quick.
What you said.
Hi. Hey, I only got a second. I'm in a rush for this meeting, but I have a quick question. As I'm looking like I'm leaving, I'm talking over the shoulder. Hey, quick question. I got to get out of here in a second. You know what I'm doing?
False time constraint.
I don't want to come up to her like this and then just stay there and go, hi.
Pretty.
I like this glove. Do you like the band? Right? And she's like, who the fuck is this guy? You ever notice like a bum approaches you on the street?
Yes.
And they just kind of get up. You know, it's like, can I have some change? You don't have any change. I'm like, well, can I have a cigarette? They don't leave. And you're like, when is this person going to leave me? What if I look like I'm leaving? Can you sit down? Yeah. Let's say she's, I wish I had two chairs like this. So, let's say she's sitting in a set, and I can say, like, I gotta go in a second. Scooch over, I gotta tell you this one quick thing. But, blah, blah, blah. And I can actually stand up in the middle of the conversation, keep talking to her. Oh, wait, well, check this out. I can lock back in.
Cool.
Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. Next slide. Positioning oneself. Lock-in positions. Yes. Positioning oneself as the center of attention in a set, and physically having the girl lean towards oneself, as in the position of power. Locking in is essential if one is running flash game, or if one wants to have a stronger presence in holding down a set with more than one HB. It is the subconscious communication of one's alphaness and value in the set based on one's physical relationship with their targets. Different lock-in tactics have been developed by the community. Okay. So I'm going to show you guys a couple lock-ins right now when you get in set. Let's say, can I put you here, kind of against the wall? Sure. Actually, can I use it too? Well, you guys can just be hanging out. So, let's say I'm actually in set, I've opened, I false time constrained. Constrained. And let's say I'm bantering with the set, and I can say, hey, high five. I can take her like this, and I can spin her, and I can take her spot. You wouldn't have moved, though, in your life. But now, I look like I have two girls gaming me. So to the rest of the club, I just grew a pair of tits.
Oh.
Now I'm locked into the set and I can continue conveying my personality. There's another one. If they were just standing here and there's no wall, I can at least turn to the side so I'm not facing her directly. If you have a wing, I can say, when I'm out with Maz, we kind of have a code, so if I say something like, to the window, he'll know, oh, wall routine. So he'll know to stand behind me so that I can lean up against him and at least have some kind of power here. I can say something like, hey, let me see your hands. Ah, that looks so much better in this light. Hey, check it out. Or, take the chair. I can do the same kind of routine. I can half lock in if I'm talking to her. I never want to talk down to a girl if she's sitting at a table, but I gotta get on her eye level right here. So I can, but I can't sit here because then it looks like who's got the power?
Looks like you're playing yourself. Oh, that's my beer. Sorry. Here, give me a napkin. Oh,
yeah.
No, I got swallowed.
Oh my God, swallowed.
That is my beer.
My bad, that was alcohol abuse.
That was funny. I'm glad you got that one on tape, because that was funny.
Yeah.
Sorry, they smoked your beer, but that was funny.
That's my beer.
It was worth it. It was worth it.
For the swallowed comments. Yeah.
Right,
here, napkin. Clean that up good at my house. Shit, you just leave it there.
Okay, take two.
Reset.
Let's move this here.
Judge yourself, don't spill beer.
Unless you swallow.
Yeah.
Exactly. That'll be our next class we teach, swallowing.
I'm not sure of it.
But we'll be teaching that.
Yeah, I will attend though just to watch.
Wow. Yeah.
I got a chair for you. So like I was saying, I can't sit down like this for too long, but I can say, obviously, actually, let me see your hand. Go like this. Stand up for a second. Okay, it's been around. Ah, I just took your chair. No, check this out. I can only stay a second, but.
You want to sit?
Cool. I think that was, we did four lock-ins. Yeah.
What about putting a hat on? Oh, I don't have to put it in that position.
Oh, that's like a lock-in prop. Different, that's like lock-in meaning too.
Next one?
Let's see. Okay, yeah. One more thing.
Thank you.
Wanna volunteer? Okay. So the reason we lock in, we have this hardwired response that triggers when someone approaches us direct. How does that feel inside?
Angry.
Right?
Like, what are you doing?
Confrontational.
Right? Yeah, very confrontational.
You don't want to do this to him. A lot of guys...
You don't want to do that to a guy either.
Oh, yeah, exactly. Sorry. You notice a lot of guys in the club, they come straight around, hey, what's going on? You do that to me? You didn't feel it though, did you?
No.
Because you were doing it, but I felt it inside. It's hardwired, it's triggered. But check this out. Now, actually, I didn't show you this one thing on the light. Now, what's interesting about this is, now see how I'm just the same distance from this guy. But you don't feel that response,
different.
Right? Because I'm not facing you. I'm actually locked in now. And if we were in set, oh, the last lock-in was, let's say I'm here and I have the wall, I can actually say, oh, hey, check this out. Hey, now I'm locked in the set.
It was cool. The same distance.
Yeah. So my quote is, whoever has the wall, has it all. Try it.
So is it just basically try to stay more shoulder to shoulder?
Yeah. Until, you don't want to stay shoulder to shoulder.
That's just the opening.
At a certain point, she's going to feel comfortable with your presence there. When then you can turn and actually have a normal conversation. But that hardwired response, that's like why the AFC dinner and a movie date doesn't work. When the two people sit at the table. And they sit there, and they're putting themselves in that position. They don't even know they're doing it. But now you're getting that response, and it becomes an interview. So if you ever like are going to meet a girl for food, take her and sit at the bar, so you guys are shoulder to shoulder. So I'm not going to continue with the opener. I just pre-open her. She knows of me. I leave, and then I'm going to come back later and actually start to open. Raising the glass, just walking around to random people in the club. Hey, cheers! Hey, what's going on? How's your night going? Cheers! And once you come back later, they're going to be more receptive to talk to you. And also, like, have you guys ever done the cheers routine? Mm-hmm. It pumps your state rate really quick, because you're talking to so many people so quick. Like, you get a lot of endorphins and adrenaline pumping up.
Confidence
makes it a lot easier.
You can walk into any place and do what you just said, and now you're not a stranger when you come back around the next time. You're that guy. You're the party guy.
Yes.
Oh, shit.
Let's see. Okay. This one, too, like the girl, your target's in a group with a guy. You can walk by the guy. Hey, high five, fist bump. Hey, what's up, man? I'm actually looking for my friend. Did you see a tall guy? He came in here. He's like 6'5", wears like a top hat and goggles.
Oh, mystery.
Actually, I'm getting texts right now. And, you know, you tell him you're getting texts, and you walk away while you're texting. So the target already saw you. She got a little bit of your personality. And then when you come back in later, you're like, oh, did you find your friend? Yeah, I don't know. Some blah. Blah. let's see. You guys seem interesting. I did that one. Okay. Say you're at the bar. A lot of times, like, you know, you sit down next to the hot girl, and most guys will sit there.
And wait for something to happen.
She's just on her phone. And if you stall out, when you open later, and you're like, so, how's it going? You're demonstrating you have, like, no balls. But if you immediately sit down at the bar and go, hey, what's up, I'm Ryan, it looks like I'm going to be your bar neighbor tonight, what's going on? Oh, hold on, actually, get a text, go to the bathroom, at least you initiated the chat, so you don't look like a creep. Let's see. Okay, the dynamic changes after a person has met you once. Even if just for a quick second, after your return, it will become a warm approach rather than a cold approach, and both parties will feel more comfortable as there is a sense of already having known each other. You said that slide?
Well, one other thing that kind of I would say, like, the time I use that the most is in clubs. If you go to a club, you meet people in the line. So you say hi to them in the line. And then when you see them in the club, you say hi to them again. And then if you want to, then after the club night's over, you can hang around, and then the people you met in the club, you can meet again. And they'll be familiar with you. It's not like being blown out, because you haven't really approached them properly, and now they recognize you, they know you, and they want to hang out with you. You know, it just kind of works within the context. Does that make, yeah.
Sure.
It's kind of the same thing, yeah.
A short setting, this is a little different than not a pre-open. You're actually going to stay in a few minutes this time, and you're not short setting in a set that you're necessarily looking for the target. The target may be on the other side of the room, but if you short set every set in the entire club, you end up building a lot of social proof. So she sees you out of the corner of her peripheral, like, oh, this guy is like knows all these people, he's high-fiving the manager, he's talking to the bartender. You stay in the set a couple minutes, and then you know, if there was a girl that was in one of those sets, you can also come back in later, like the pre-open. So short setting. The practice of quickly opening up multiple sets in a venue in order to establish social proof. Short setting is a technique that PUAs use in order to build up their social value and get into a social state, rather than focusing on opening just the woman they are interested in. With short setting, the PUA works the entire room, staying in for no more than a few minutes before moving on to the next group of people. Short setting has a number of benefits. First, it helps the PUA to get into the social mode by getting them talking to large numbers of people, similar to warm-up sets. Short setting also has the benefit of building social proof, as the PUA is seen talking to everyone in the venue instead of just hitting on some girls. This raises the social value of the PUA and makes opening subsequent sets easier. Finally, by short setting, the PUA is able to introduce himself to everyone in the room, which allows him to later reopen sets he talked to earlier and get a warmer reception than if he had just approached them cold. Short setting can be as simple as going around the room giving toasts, high fives, or actually going around introducing oneself to different sets. Whatever method the PUA uses, the idea with short setting is to stay in set for no more than a few minutes and leave the set on a high note whenever possible. All right, so that was fun. Reopening. The act of re-engaging a set that was previously opened with initial greeting can also be coined as a warm approach. Reopening is one of the keys to creating strong social proof within a venue. The idea of reopening resolves around the fact that the initial open cannot directly lead to sex. As such, the PUA can first engage a new set by simply saying hello. The next time he sees them at the bar, he can say hi again, and the cold approach thus becomes warmer. The more sets that can be reopened, the more social proof the PUA has within the venue. Sometimes a girl is simply too preoccupied within the club environment to go home with you on the first encounter. She has her friends, she has her cell phone, her drinks, she's dancing. As such, reopening her in a way that adds value, or reopening another set of hot babes that make her jealous, may be key to making her feel attraction for you. approach priming, which is kind of that game that we were playing a second ago. The idea of priming and prepping for an approach in order to set it up for the highest chance of success. Guys get nervous on the approach. As such, the technique of approach priming was invented. It was first explored extensively in gambler stealth attraction techniques. The idea is centered around priming for pre-approaching and setting yourself up for success. Some techniques that warm up the initial approach are being seen talking to another hot girl with an unbreakable opener before her and then walking away first. Forcing an IOI or indicator of interest with a wave or a toast. Eye contact, holding and forcing her to look away to give an IOI. In the case of an IOD, you know not to approach her right now if this is your first set. Setting yourself up in a positive mood. Group merging or going, getting another girl to introduce her to you. Approach priming works good if you're really nervous in the beginning. I still approach prime. I do approach priming. Actually, before I go out, I have a whole kind of meditation ritual. I take a lot of focus factor vitamins, ginseng, ginkgo biloba to get my brain kind of working so I'm not going to go blank. Red Bull, Monster Energy drinks. Good.
It's actually a new thing that's like that's for AA. I just got like an email about it like a week ago. I don't remember what it is, but I'll have to look forward to send it to you.
Send it.
It's supposed to be like completely rid you of like all that stuff. Mm-hmm. It's like one thing.
Is it cocaine?
Yeah.
Okay, go. Next slide.
Yeah, this is the next slide.
Oh, yeah.
I'm
so
thinking like that.
Definition of a warm approach. An approach on a woman with whom the POA is already acquainted, or who shows some interest in him. The warm approach is a blanket term used to refer to any approach that is not a cold approach on a complete stranger. Usually this takes place during social circle game, where both the POA and the girl have a mutual friend in common. That commonality is usually enough to break the ice and make starting a conversation and a relationship with her a lot easier than if the POA had just run into her in the street. A warm approach can also be used to refer to when a pickup artist reopens a set that he previously opened and left on a positive note. For example, using the technique of short setting, a pickup artist may very quickly meet and talk to everyone in the venue, even though the POA is only able to give a brief introduction of himself in the time. Just that little bit of a connection is usually enough to make the POA's next approach a warmer one. POAs also use the term warm approach to refer to easy approaches. In this context, a warm approach can mean approaching a girl who is throwing out heavy IOIs, or approaching someone in a situation where the pickup artist is heavily socially proofed. A warm approach in these cases is an easy approach on someone who is at least somewhat interested, rather than approach on a stranger who hasn't shown the slightest bit of interest. A warm approach versus cold approach is approaching and opening a girl or a set that the POA has never met before. Average frustrated chumps and some naturals often argue that cold approaches are not necessary if one has a growing social circle of which he can get girlfriends from. Gambler argues in The Natural Art of Seduction that the cold approach is what gives us ultimate choice to meet a girl who is not part of your life and having the skill set to make her part of your reality. Mystery states the cold approach pickup. It is a beautiful art form. Ultimately, any successful POA has had his share of cold approaches in order to get where he is today. 3-second rule. You guys know this one?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Nope.
Okay. The 3-second rule is a rule that says you must approach a set within 3 seconds of opening them, or 3 seconds of seeing them, or them seeing you. The 3-second rule is a guideline that many POAs follow to overcome approach anxiety. Hesitating too much before an approach can lead to overthinking and nervousness, and can also creep a set out if they notice you staring at them for too long. Opening a set within 3 seconds allows you to be in the moment more. It doesn't give you enough time to come up with excuses for not approaching the set. We call this analysis paralysis. Even the best POAs have approach anxiety, thus the 3-second rule is the counter for this natural fear from our biological mechanism. We're actually doing the 1-second rule now. You guys heard that one?
No.
It's just like that one, but it's like 2 seconds shorter. Community humor. Okay, go ahead.
Okay.
Yeah, if you see him, don't even hesitate. Just walk in and blast that set open. Hey guys, what's up? The more you sit there and you think and you start backward rationalizing, you create like As we see in pictures, you'll see like across the scroll of your mind, like so many reasons why it's not going to work out, so many reasons why she's going to, you know, reject you. Oh my God, she's going to slap you, she's going to throw your drink. And then you just stand there and you freeze, and then she's gone. So just go in. Okay. Oh, thanks. False time constraints. Verbal FTCs. A statement a pickup artist makes when opening a set to communicate that he will not be able to remain long, to reassure them that he will not take up too much of their time. Developed by style, the FTC helps to keep sets from getting annoyed by the presence of a new stranger. Whenever people meet someone who they don't know, they feel a certain amount of concern about how much time this person is going to take up with them. FTCs have a subtle effect of preemptively dissuading such feelings and also making the presence of the PUA more valued, as he may leave at any minute, which creates a feeling of scarcity. FTCs allow the PUA enough time to reach the hook point, at which point the group or target will try to get the PUA to stay. Here's a couple stock canned FTCs, should write these down. So before your opener, I gotta get back to my friends real quick, so I only have a minute. But I wanted to ask you guys' opinion on something. I can only stay a second. I'm here with friends. I gotta get back to my friends in a second, but I'm curious about something.
What, friends?
Yes.
Yeah, run, yes. Can you run to your car?
I have meetings every day.
Yes.
I always bring my notepad for Ryan.
It's good. That way you guys don't have the paper. I'll give you all the answers right now. Beer break. Ready to go?
Yes.
Okay. Who lies more open? So this is like the classic community opener. Now, when you write these down in set, you don't want to do these verbatim. You want to do them concept for concept. You have to be able to do these on the fly, because she's going to have a different response. You're going to have to calibrate to her behavior, to the way that the her friends are receptive to your opener. But who lies more? Hey guys, who do you think lies more? Men or women? Who do you guys think lies more? Men or women? Who do you guys think lies more?
Women. We don't have the guts to tell people the truth.
What about you?
Men.
Yeah. That's what I thought. See, I think men lie more, but like women lie bigger. Because men, you ever met with a guy, and you're like, where were you last night? And you know he smelled like perfume. He's at the strip club making it rain. And he's like, oh, I was at Chuck's house. Right? But women, they'll look at you and they'll be like, yeah, it's your baby.
I told you that story in secret. Just kidding.
See where it hits? See where the laugh comes in? Now I've just demonstrated humor and confidence. Without having to actually tell her, hey, I'm a funny guy. I'm a confident guy. I'm demonstrating that.
That just went down.
Uh-oh.
Did you guys get that one?
Here we
one
go. Time? Here we go. Yes.
Cool. Dental floss. Hey, guys. I have an absolutely empirical question. The fate of humanity can depend on your answer. Dental floss. Before or after you brush?
Before.
After.
See, no, it is no one knows the
before.
Answer.
No, it is actually before.
No,
that was it.
After. So, yeah.
That's what the two set will do. One will say before, one will say after. See, no one knows the
my
answer.
My ex is a dentist,
cut
it's before.
And stack.
Yeah,
my ex is a dentist. It's actually before, because when you're in there, you're getting stuff
yeah,
out. You want to brush it away and wash
well,
it out.
Then you mouthwash it away.
That is the second part of it. When you have a target and an obstacle, and what let's say the target says after, this is like the part two of it. You can bag on her because the obstacle will say before. You high-five the obstacle, create a jealousy plot line in the target. And you say, yeah, dude, why would I want to brush it after, dude? Right? You don't have to even take it that far. You can just put dental floss before, after you brush, before, after. See, no one knows the answer. Hey, get this. The other day, you cut and stacked your next routine. Remember I said, like, you're just using the opener to open.
Right.
Spells. This is also, this can be used as an opener if you use it short, or you can use it in set as a routine. Do you guys believe in spells? Or Do you guys think spells work? Okay, get this. My buddy, he was dating this girl, but like, I don't know, he wasn't that into her, right? It was something with her smell. I don't know what it, you know when people smell is just not right? But anyway, they end up having sex, and the next morning, she went to go fix him breakfast, and he went to get his shoes. He's getting dressed, and he goes under the bed, and he sees this little bag. The best way to describe it is like a little, like, kind of mesh, like, potpourri bag. It had, like, a little note with, like, a scroll. Like, you ever seen the movie Lord of the Rings, and it had, like, that elfish writing? It was weird. But inside there was, like, these bones. Not like, they weren't dirty then. They were clean bones. But he was like, what the fuck is this? So he took it from her, and he calls me up, and he's like, dude, this chick is like, I don't know, come check this out. So we went, and I looked at it, and I was like, I don't know. It looked like something out of World of Warcraft or something like that. But I was thinking, you know, there's this shop that sells candles over in Summerlin. I like to, you know, put a lot of candles in my apartment because, you know, I like the smell and the incense. And I was thinking, this little lady over there, she probably knows, you know, what this is. So we go over there, and we show it to her, and she just looks at it, and she's like, it's an attraction spell. And she looks at us like we're crazy. I'm thinking, like, we're guys. We don't know that shit. And anyway, so we didn't think anything of it. He put it back under the bed. And this was like a couple months ago. And now, like, every time I see him on Facebook, he's updating his wall of, like, how much he's, like, super in love with her. He can't get her out of his head. So do you think the spell worked, or is it all bullshit?
It's like one of those five-minute openers you were talking about.
Yeah, usually, if when you use it on the open, it's long. But if you wait and use it in set, it hits a lot more. And the weird part about that, the last time I used this was on, like, a hairdresser. And I was sitting there, like, I opened her with, you know, let me get the haircut. And I was like, okay, this is, like, the first time I want to try this routine. And I'm sitting up there, and she's blabbing away, and I was just like, dude, I got a question for you. I need to feel my opinion. Do you think spells work? So I went through the routine, and for the next half an hour, she goes off on this tangent. She's like, yeah, you should know that. I'm a white witch, and blah, blah, blah. And I'm thinking, like, the fuck is a white witch? And this conversation went for like another half an hour with her, you know, talking about how she, you know, is into witchcraft and spells. The word spells and the word energy and psychology, those are like these magic words you can say in a conversation to a woman to get her like, oh, what's this? This is different. It's interesting. You guys, can we do that one again three more times? Mm-hmm. Thank God, I hate that one.
Good. I hate that one too.
Okay. Girls and tattoos. Mm. Hey guys.
I love tattoos. Me too.
What do you guys think about girls and tattoos?
Y'all think they're hot.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Only tramp sex.
Mine are on my back. My neck.
It's okay.
I have mine when I was I have a slave stamp.
I just don't like the ones up here with like a hook. You know,
no.
On a girl.
I have my
attractive.
Slave stamp. It's okay.
Slave.
I secretly have. So you have
some? Yep.
Well, get this. My little sister, she's 19, and she's been dating this guy Steve for like 2 months. She wants to get his name tattooed on her shoulder.
Fuck that.
No, not like this, like down like this, Steve. How do I tell her not to get this tattoo?
Can't.
Oh, stop. That was good.
It's
that was good.
Oh, that is a good one.
So your answer would be something like?
You're crazy.
I'm crazy?
No, I'm crazy. She's crazy.
Yeah. Well, that's the thing. I'm her older brother, and if I tell her not to get it, she's just going to want to get it that much more. But what's up with that? Snip and stack.
Really
one more time?
No.
Sorry.
That one's perfect. That was like one of the first ones you turned me on to.
You're making me so hot.
I know.
Jealous girlfriend. You said you used that one before, right?
Yeah.
Hey guys, quick question. My friend's girlfriend found pictures of an ex underneath the bed. She told him to burn them, or she's going to break up with him. What's up with that?
I can imagine someone told him to burn that.
Say that one again.
My friend's girlfriend found pictures of his ex underneath their bed. She told him to burn them, or she's going to break up with him. What's up with that? Or what do you think about that?
Hide them. Why the hell would you leave them under the bed? Shit. Jeez. Mm-hmm. I have better.
So you open with that. She's going to give her response. She's either going to say one of two things. She's going to, right away you're kind of qualifying, you're going to see what kind of girl she is. She's either going to say like, Fuck yeah! My friend did that. My ex had those. I should have told him to burn them. Or she's gonna say, I don't know. That's kind of psycho. And then you can proceed to say, yeah, that's what I told him. I told him to leave her. Like, personally, I'm a really sentimental guy. Like, I have all my old yearbooks from high school. Blah. Snip and stack. Cool. Herman. Hey, guys. Would you ever date a guy named Herman?
No.
Okay, get this. My buddy Herman is never good with the ladies. A month ago, we decided to change his name to Steve. Getting laid like a fucking rock star now.
It's like the Sherbinator. Herminator.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, if I had a girl named Beatrice, I don't know if I could deal with that.
Beatrice. Oh, she's the fat chick you used to date.
It's like Betty, too.
You know about that?
Change her name.
I do.
All Natashas are hot.
That's true. All Natashas are hot.
All Natashas are hot.
That is
good.
True.
Isn't
very
it?
True.
Gigi's don't date those.
Yeah.
Bertha
shouldn't have been a fat chick.
Bertha's a tough one.
Bertha's a fat chick. She's not fat now, she can be fat later.
Wait a minute, I'm looking forward to this next one. I want to see what this is all about.
Herman.
Do you know why you suck? That's what you do.
I know that.
Do you know why you suck?
Uh-huh.
I have been trying to meet you for 10 minutes, but you, Miss Popular, are surrounded by all these people. I can't even get close to you. You suck. Who are you?
That's pretty strong.
Who are you? And she answers, I'm Cindy. And you cross your arms. And that's special because?
I think like...
So wait, I'm trying to pick up on lingo. So it's like you gave her a negative, and then you brought it, then he came back. Boy, you're really like bouncing around there.
Mm-hmm.
Push pull.
Yeah. You know what's the weirdest
push,
part
pull.
About this?
Push-pull. That was
one.
The phrase I
yeah.
was looking for.
We were out doing an event called Sargeopoly, where I dress up like a Monopoly man, and you know, the Monopoly dude has a top hat, and I put weird random openers in it, and the guys would like, you know, you would put $5 in the thing and draw a challenge from the hat. If you go and reach the hook point and get the number, you get your $5 back. If you get blown out of set, the $5 goes to the, you know, beer money fund. And there was a girl that I had a challenge on, and then I told her what we were doing, and she's like, oh, that's fun, I want to play. She draws the, do you know why you suck? She's like, well, what do I do with this? I was like, find a guy, go up and say, open the conversation with, do you know why you suck? And she's like, what do I say next? I was like, you figure it out, improv. This guy walks by with this huge, like, cowboy hat, like a sombrero thing. And it's enormous. She turns around and she goes, do you know why you suck? And he's like, why? And she's like, your hat's not big enough.
That's a good one.
And he cracks up, and they actually ended up having dinner that night at Blue Martini. Random, dude. Do you know why you suck?
It's a good one, is it?
David Bowie, Mick Jagger, it's like the same opener. Hey, guys. Do you guys think Mick Jagger is hot? He's like 80 years old. My little niece has a poster of him on the wall. Like when she wakes up, like a huge wall-sized poster. This is what she wakes up to. She's 7. He's like 70. What do you think about that?
Nice.
Like, do girls really think that's hot?
The ones that have daddy issues do.
Mm. All right, direct openers. You guys ever done, we're done with indirect now, so you guys ever done any direct?
And
I've met a lot of successful.
Wait, what did you say?
Okay, it's an acquired taste.
You gotta come really confident, really ballsy, really dominant, powerful, very congruent with you are, with who you are. So here's a couple stock canned direct openers. First one, absolutely adorable. So you're gonna come up to her, hand out. Hey. I gotta get back to my friends in a second, but I thought you were absolutely, pause, adorable, and I had to come meet you. My name's Ryan. When you do that little pause, she's like, I just thought you were absolutely, she's like, what?
The biggest bitch in the room.
And then you relieve the tension. You bring the tension, release it. Take a number.
Take a number.
Yeah,
nice.
Take a number.
Well, you're really cool.
Yes. I just thought you were absolutely adorable, or like absolutely super cute, and I had to come meet you because if I didn't, I'd be kicking myself in the ass for the rest of the day. My name's Ryan. Handshake, give her a fist bump. Yeah. Usually, what I do with this one is then I'll say, like, I've really got to get going, but, you know, are you on Facebook? And then I'll, you know, Facebook close, grab the number. Or if she's walking, then you can start walking with her. Snip and stack. You know, what nationality are you? Blah. Whatever. Sexy and beautiful. Remember this from the bad boy one? Oh, actually, I need you. This one.
Me? Hi. No, I'm going to swallow this.
Take your time.
In the group.
That's a different class. Brian, remember that's my direct.
That's the class I teach.
Remember that's my direct
level. Oh, I'm sorry. That's
do you remember my direct
over? Class.
Do you spot?
Oh, that's right. That's
you guys were busting my balls because I use that as my direct opener. I go up to him and I just go, excuse me, do you swallow?
I like that one.
And
I like
I've got
lines.
More play out of that than probably any other direct.
Hold
because
on,
they're so
pause
surprised.
For a second.
You just ask them,
girls
do they
like
swallow?
Dirty lines. We're not,
I go
here.
Up, if there's at least four of them, I just go up, there's four hotties, I just go up, excuse me, do you swallow? And they're in such shock. They go to town on each other, and they can't believe that I have big enough balls to actually say that in front of four women. But I don't say much.
Or
I just let them go to town.
You're taking a survey of how many people swallow.
Excuse me, do you swallow? And that's all I said. And these guys were busting my balls on it, but I've been using this.
I'm sorry, I'm stealing that.
You should.
We'll call him Chevron.
All my life.
That's the one you should have the absolutely most attractive. Because they wouldn't expect that in a million
crazy
years.
Girls.
Is that really
ones
direct?
Are like
because
wild,
that's kind
yeah.
of.
Hey,
wild.
I'm not wild. And I like it.
That's the one you like salad.
I mean,
it works
yeah.
for me.
I gotta write that down.
Do you swallow?
The answer is yes.
Target.
Yes.
Down a little bit.
I know.
It's a long night.
At least my heart is
seriously.
She needs another shot,
I think.
Oh,
yeah.
You know,
she wants
too
many shots is a problem.
What I need
no,
to do.
Let's just imagine
one.
That you guys are in set. Mm-hmm. You're going to get over
oh.
here.
Yes.
And you guys are just kind of talking.
Hi, how are you?
No,
I never say that.
Oh, we know each other.
Yeah.
Okay.
You guys can come in.
And the Giants play next
week. Oh,
weekend.
You're coming in. I got it.
You guys are just
yeah.
talking.
Blah, blah, blah.
You're
going
to come in,
blah,
hand
blah,
on.
Blah.
Not
Work
like this,
sucks.
not grabbing. Turn around. You are so damn sexy and beautiful.
And
I,
then that's when I start busting up laughing.
Who are you? What's your name?
I'm Chris.
Now, see how I didn't stop when I said you're sexy and beautiful? Because if I pause there, she's going to say, thanks, I'm with friends. I immediately went in, you're opening the question. Who are you? What's your name? And proceed from there. If there's like a guy in the group, hey, I'm Ryan, what's going on? And then have your wing come in and mini ISO with him. And
can I pause for just one moment and ask you a question?
Who are you?
This.
What?
Who are you? Open in a question.
Yeah, like, who are you? What's your name?
Yeah.
You're like, you know, Kristen.
The concept of going up to. I can understand going up to one girl, two girl, group of girls. But going up to a group where there's also guys seems to me like a non-starter.
Guys are just ugly chicks.
Yeah.
That's good. I've never heard that one.
Or you can tell
that
if this girl
is
not comfortable with talking. Like maybe they're talking to some guy. They're like, this guy needs to go away. Rolling their eyes or something. They need something.
So never assume.
Never
those guys just
on.
Might.
Your,
those guys might want to
yeah.
sleep with her, but she might not want to sleep
she's
with
them. She's not interested. She's probably
right.
like,
I almost
I don't
prefer when
away.
I took when he
right.
took me out to the first Friday for the first time. I only hit on chicks that were with guys. When I
really?
Got, he was telling me mm-hmm. go hit on these ones because she might be with you, but she doesn't want to sleep with you.
Interesting.
Yeah. Another version.
That
of
seems
that
the
okay.
biggest
guys can
wall in my mind. I'm trying to get rid of right now.
Call that a sticking point. So we're gonna break through that.
Okay.
If you have approach anxiety, guys are actually easy to approach. Like, stop chatting to a guy, and then you can, like,
right,
get attention
for sure.
That. So guys are a lot easier. And then if you're friends with them, then they won't block you later.
Right. Check this one out. Another version of that. If you're spinning around talking to him, you can come in.
No! No!
Like, get the fuck back here!
Oh, wait, do that one again. Do that one again.
Ryan, that's as bad.
That's good.
Yeah. I'm just fucking with you. My name's Ryan. What's going on? I thought you were.
Oh, shit.
Okay. Apocalypse opener. This
I love that one, dude.
Wait, I got to kind of take notes on the one. Give me a second to take notes on that. That was good, Ryan.
Take your time.
I don't know if I can do that.
I can't believe you're doing the apocalypse up here.
He's going to love this one.
Yeah. Yeah, it sounds like it.
That's actually good.
Fuck that. I'm gonna make
once you get ballsy enough, you should be able to just go in. Start making out.
Do you swallow? That's good night, everybody.
Oh, you haven't gotten to the good one yet.
That's good.
Okay,
that's funny.
This one.
That's fun.
This next one is for you. Apocalypse opener, four lines.
Yeah.
You open. Hey, what's up? How's your night going? What are you doing later? Do you want to come home with me?
That's
hold.
It.
Hold.
Yeah.
Just hold.
Gotta maintain.
Just back the back out.
One, two, three, four.
One and more time.
At that point, okay.
We
hey, what's up?
Pause and let her answer, but
how's your night going? What are you doing later? Do you want to come home with me? And then hold. In parentheses, hold at the end. Because at that point, she's going to be checking for any kind of incongruence. Like, are you really the man who just came up to me and fucking said that?
All right.
Are you this guy? You can't look away. You can't, like, put your hands in your pockets. You can't...
No hesitation.
You can't rock around,
balls
fidget.
No weakness.
Just, yeah. Balls of fucking platinum.
All she can say is yes or no. It's like
what was three and four? I'm slow.
Hey, what's up? How's your night going?
What are you doing later?
What are you doing later?
Do you want to come home?
Do you want to come home with me?
Now, why... I'm asking why. Why would you choose to use that one?
Why not?
I saw one guy.
The point is
posted.
To do something different.
Right. I don't know how true it is, but this guy said that he was getting a percentage of like maybe if you went to a mall and you did this, he's getting about a 15% ratio.
Like of yes on the fourth question.
Yeah.
Yeah. This
if you do that 10 times, you get 1.5
so
times.
So it could possibly be a number game.
This is great. A blog this guy puts in, and I think it's what you're talking about. I think it was on Pickup.
I think it was Attraction Forums, actually.
Attraction Forums?
Yeah.
And this guy, he uses the line, hey, my name's Joe, what's your name? And she's like, whatever, Colleen. And you're like, well, Colleen, now that we're on the same basis, let's go back to my place and fuck.
Yeah.
And that's the line.
Right.
And he, in great detail, does one set after another in like huge details. Like I approach a seven on the on the bench at like a university, and I use the line, and she laughs, and he comes up with statistics, and he's like, one in every 16 said yes,
right.
You know, one in every 20 would hit me, one in every.
But go back to the.
That wasn't the one.
It was the one in 16
like
though,
yeah.
And that's good. Like yeah. Imagine if you're skateboarding or something. If you don't fall, you're not trying hard enough, right?
Right.
So you're not
all right.
Exactly.
Okay.
Push it to the limit.
Just for fun, you gotta all do it right. Once
yeah.
in a while. You know?
But the key though, like when you're doing this direct
what
stuff, you gotta remember this. A lot of guys learn the wrong game. They got dumb.
They
say there's two kinds of girls in the one or three kind, whatever. But one is like you know an emotional girl who's looking for a relationship. So when you go in direct with her, she likes that. She likes that response. And then there's a girl that came to the club to fuck. She put on her boots,
right.
Shaved her legs, shaved her pussy, she smells good, she's looking for a guy who's going to come. You ever go into the bar and start noticing the girl who's sitting on the edge of the bar just sitting there texting by herself.
Right.
Take her, pull her to the bathroom.
They also say at the end of the night when the bar is closing or whatever, or when the club is closing, like outside, that's a good place to do it.
Yep.
When they've given up, you know.
A lot of times, we're not even going to the club anymore.
We have
like,
no morale left.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Pick us up, we'll take you home.
Keep us from crying at home alone.
No, it's us guys that are willing to take you girls home. Okay.
It's like we practice and we train, so we already have a handicap, and then we go find the drunk girl, and it's like, double handicap. We're cheating, I don't know.
Right. That's definitely cheating.
Let's see, any cheesy pickup line, we went over that before, and anything in just instantaneous telegraphing interest, like you were saying. You know, now that we know each other, let's go fuck. Nice shoes, hey, let's fuck. It's all direct. Next slide. Okay,
wow.
So before the open, they can actually pre-open to turn it into a warm approach.
Pre-opening a set is meeting them briefly, then ejecting before returning later to begin your normal routine. A pre-open will last 5 to 10 seconds maximum. You will offer the set a piece of value and a takeaway. You will not FTC, you will actually leave. Give your name before leaving. Leave before the hook point is reached. An example, to a hired gun. I walk in, I give a random high five. Hey, what's up? We're talking to like a hot bartender or a waitress that you're trying to hit on. You see her instantly. Hey, what's up? Hey, I'm Ryan. I actually got an appointment with the urinal, but can you give me a Henny and Coke and meet me by the bar? Some good ones that kind of force them to open. Talk to me later about that. Stuff like, instead of hi, you might want to put capital WTF, ? To make her say, well, what the fuck is this? And then you're going to have a completely different kind of script. In fact, usually you use like a lot of time management and online gaming. So there's one message that works really good that I use, and you just copy and paste that into every girl's profile. Okay. Eye coding. Sometimes you don't even have to use any words to start a conversation. I can look at the girl. Now I know if I make eye contact with a girl, she's going to do 4 different things. Let's say I look at the girl, if you were me, and you were looking... That was way out of context. Let's say I'm looking at the girl, and she looks up and away. What do you guys think she's saying?
Not interested.
You caught me looking.
Yes? It's not that she's saying, I'm not interested. She's saying, I can't be approached at this time. Her boyfriend could be standing next to her. Her shield's up. You haven't built any attraction. It's not saying don't go in. It's not saying it won't happen. But be mindful when you get that. Let's say she looks to the side and then gives you this. What do you think she's saying?
Seeing if anybody else noticed that you're looking
there. Meet me for a quickie in the bathroom.
You too close?
I hate it when that happens.
Insta-fuck. Check it out.
7 minutes.
She's saying, notice me.
Got a big nose?
Notice me.
No, you don't. I'm just saying.
I'm not Jewish. Let's see. Let's say she looks down, back up.
She
knows the answer.
Should be in a little coy.
Basically asking a question, asking you to come to her.
Approach me. Mm-hmm. Approach me now. Put your beard down, leave your friends, and come talk to me.
Look at your pants. Yep.
Mm-hmm.
You're really looking at
your pants. Yeah.
You're looking at the pants?
Yeah. It's like,
yeah. Looking for what's in them?
Yep. Or what's not.
Fair enough. Oblique openers. This is where I go into set, and I don't even have to actually talk to... Actually, can you guys come up here?
That's us.
You didn't need to go on this one.
Okay, here. Not for me.
Put it on the...
Chris, yes.
If you guys could draw a position like here and here.
Position over here. I'm just kidding.
Okay. So let's say Chris is my target here. I don't even have to go up and talk to her directly. And if I did in the set, I'd be completely ignoring friend. But I can go up, open the conversation with our friend, and obliquely demonstrate my value and upload it into her head. When I'm sitting here telling this girl about myself and conveying my personality, she can still hear me. So then, when I do turn and talk to this girl, my value's already uploaded. So now it's not a cold approach, it's a warm approach. She's going to be much more receptive to that. Thanks, guys. Those also work like if you're up on stage, say, like, karaoke is great, because she can already see you, and if you're kicking ass up there, she's going to want to meet you. Kino. She has no Kino.
Touching.
Kinesthetic, short for touch. That's any kind of opener. I need you again.
Just one? Go, Chris.
Just one.
Go, Chris. God, I keep things riding at my ass.
I can kino on the opener. Hey, what's up? High five. How's your night going?
kidding.
I already broke a physical barrier in the first second. You ever go... That's not Sean.
No, that's all.
So, imagine, you guys ever gone on a, like, an AFC date, taking the girl to dinner, the movie, and you haven't even, like, put your arm around her, you haven't even touched her, and you're just like, God, I don't know. And at the end of the night, you're walking her to the door, and it's just like, oh, thanks, I had a good time. And then there's that big, awkward moment of, oh, is she going to kiss me? I don't know. I had a great time. You guys ever have that?
Never.
Never.
Well, if you have...
You break that instantly at the very, very beginning. That's the first thing you do.
As soon as you open, start building Kino. Little taps on the elbow, high fives, fist bumps, maybe a half hug and then push her off you. IOI, calibrate with the IOD. Gesture. Watch if she returns the gesture.
Oh, that's good. I like that one. Where's the
leader?
Or... It's an opener. Opinion opener?
Calm down, girl. It's
okay. Have you guys ever done any opinion openers?
G-string.
G-string?
Yeah.
What is an opinion opener? G-string. I use the generic one.
Yeah?
Jealous girlfriend one.
Okay, cool. An opinion opener is when I'm going to open a conversation with, hey, guys, I got a quick question. I got to get back to my friends, but I need an opinion on something. Or I need a female opinion, I need a guy's opinion. My little sister thinks men lie more. What do you guys think? Who lies more, men or women? Okay.
That's good. There's no yes or no in it. You force someone to engage in a conversation.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Situational opener?
Who cares?
Hey, how you guys liking this meeting? Situational. I'm in the bar. I have my bar neighbor right here. Talk about the football game. Talk about what are you guys drinking? Something that's going on in the moment. Focus opener? Something she's focusing on. She's in Starbucks and she's reading a book. Dude, is that Anne Rice? Oh my, hold on a second. Boom. And she's engaged. Flopsy is like the focus opener, but it's something you're anticipating that she's about to focus on. Let's imagine you're in Barnes & Noble, and she's about to pick a book off the shelf, and you say, no, you don't want that book. It sucked, I read it. But this one right here, check this out. That was fun. Improvisational, making some off the spot. There's an Asian dude in the group, and He has the... His openers is, booga booga. he just comes up and says something random.
He's drunk.
You have to have the look to pull that one out.
He does some weird shit, but he's got a girlfriend now. It works.
Booga booga?
Yeah, that works for you guys.
Hell no!
Any cheesy pickup line, you know, usually two C's.
Shit, if you're
going to
be like that.
Cheesy pickup lines, They're a way to open, but they're not necessarily going to work if you actually come up. The way to win with a cheesy pickup line is, one, if she's already attracted to you, it really doesn't matter what you're going to say. But if you want to open with a cheesy pickup line and she's already attracted to you, then you have to do it to the absurd, like super cheesy, like, so, it's just what I thought, made in heaven.
Oh, God,
but she already likes, yeah, it's terrible. Right, and I bet if a guy, if you didn't know the guy, right?
The room is.
They
do work though.
Yeah,
the cheesy. I still use what's your sign.
Come here often.
Time you get an
awesome. What's your sign? And that's all you have to say, and they just start laughing and laughing.
Hell yeah.
I need to get some of those.
Random chains. Opener, it's like the improvisational kind of same thing, just different lingo. Blowout openers, have you guys ever used those?
Mm-mm. What is that?
What does that one mean?
Bye, Chris. I'll take your beer. No, go ahead. Hello, goodbye.
Hey, could you just, like, blow me out?
What is that mean?
Yeah, just give me your worst rejection. I'm with my friends, we're gonna go pick up some girls, and, I just want you to just warm me up for the night. Just, tell me to fuck off. Tell me
anything. What's your worst rejection you've ever given a guy?
To give you a rejection?
You can't even do it.
Damn, she's really nice.
No,
he's an asshole. Go away, douchebag.
With a smile.
Is that the best you can do?
A smile and a laugh?
I eat nice girls like you for breakfast. Okay, thank you.
How do you mean meaner?
It throws them off, like a perfect example, so much that it actually starts getting fun.
Do they know what that means, the blowout?
I mean,
she didn't ever kind of tell her a little bit.
I know.
But some girls will. For example, there was a four set, and I was with my wing, and the primary was at the bar getting some drinks, and his target was in the group. So me and the wing rolled in, and he's like, hey guys, can you blow me out? She's like, what? And we're like, just give us your worst rejection. They look at each other, and they're like, oh, we don't do that. In fact, my friend thought you were kind of cute, and we actually wanted you to talk to us.
No shit, huh?
What? Well, actually, we're just here with my friend. He's a magician. He's in town staying at my place for the weekend. And then he comes in right at that time. He's like, hey, beer for you, beer for you. We're like, hey, meet these cool girls. They're not weird or anything. Hey, this is blah.
Huh.
And he was gone with the girl. Me and my wing held off the other three for like another half an hour, wherever they went. I don't know, food or something. Hmm. Compliment opener. Kind of lame. If you do, I like your shoes, right? It gets her the opportunity to say, thanks, I have a boyfriend, and she's gone. But if you say, I noticed myself noticing your necklace, does that have a meaning behind it? Now, she can't really say thank you. Again, open-ended question, like you said. Cool, slide. There's more different types of openers. That's what I came up with off the top of my head. Okay. I wish you guys had some paper.
Hello.
You have any paper?
You didn't tell us to bring paper.
I have coloring books.
I have notebooks in my car.
You want coloring books? I got coloring books.
Yeah, because I was going to... It's better if you write them down so that you can, reinforce your brain to...
Go get them, please.
I can go get them.
Do you have pen and paper in your car?
Yeah, I always have some paper.
Yeah. Do you want to hit stop on the video?
Do you want me to go get it?
Yes.
I have a whole...
How long have you guys, I know you guys are into the game, do you know anything about the A1 phase, if I said that?
A little bit. No. I don't know what that means. Going right over my head.
Perfect.
Okay. Blank slate. Okay. Blank slate for that.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Great. You guys
Action,
are
right? Yeah.
Okay, so if you take the entire phase of human courtship from the time you make initial eye contact with a woman all the way to... getting her in bed somewhere around here, going through a relationship, going through the breakup, the divorce, and never seeing her again. We're actually gonna, I want you to imagine you're on the top of a skyscraper, kind of looking down at this timeline, and pull out your magnifying glass, and we're gonna zoom in today for the next 2 hours on the first 2 to 3 minutes. So the reason that's so important, first impressions are everything, right? So.
Yep. Right.
Tables are here, right? Yeah. Cheers.
So today we're gonna I'm gonna give you guys some openers, pre-scripted routines that are designed to convey certain personality traits, certain alpha traits to get women attracted to you, to get them engaged in the conversation. Ways to come in under the radar to get through the bitch shield. You guys ever encountered the bitch shield?
Yes.
It's like, hold on.
You two are bystanders.
No more drinking.
Targets.
Yes.
I didn't know
that. Okay, we can go to the next slide. This is my contact information for you guys, and you don't have any pens or paper, so use your download into your head.
You got your card.
You got cards.
Cool. Yeah, I got your card.
You can go to the next slide. All right, so I want to talk about the social mask. Essentially, what we're doing in this game is we're putting on a mask. People wear these their whole lives. I know that you guys, on your own, when you're in your room by yourself, you probably act a little different than you do, say, when you're with your parents in church or when you're with your buddies at a football game, right?
So what we're doing is we fashioned a special mask for you to put on. You can kind of hide behind the material that you're going to show, so that when you come in the set, you'll be able to demonstrate confidence, dominance, power, charisma to that girl without appearing too needy.
Yeah. It's like the star right now. Like the star of attention.
It's bright. Man. It's really bright.
Really bright
here.
Need a taco?
Yeah. That sounds really good. No, I can't. I skipped the gym tonight.
So I'm going to read this for you guys since it's like micro. The social mask. A false persona or facade used to garner attention and feel socially accepted. We all have different sides to our personality. We may be one person with our lover, another with our neighbor. We wear a different mask at church than we do with our buddies at a football game. We act, think, and behave differently with different people in different social situations in order to effectively meet the demands of different kinds of challenges and opportunities. In our daily life, we encounter hundreds, if not thousands, of people depending on the current activity we're undertaking, and to all of them, we project a different image of ourselves, to our friends, our family, our neighbors, our teachers, and to others. We do this in hopes of being socially accepted by our peers, enough so that we're willing to change ourselves completely for this acceptance. In terms, we project a different persona, one that in hopes others will take a liking to in order for us to be included as part of the group. We say things we normally wouldn't, we act in a different manner, and our choices and preferences often change to suit those of others. Everyone wears a mask for everything, in friendships, job interviews, even in relationships with wives, husbands, and other family members. Every social situation of your life, you've probably been wearing this mask. Most people do not understand that they have the power to either control the mask or let the mask control them. So in this game, through the attraction, comfort, and seduction phases, you must know when and how to use the mask, and when to take it off, and when to quickly put it back on if you need it. Learning to use a mask is like learning to ride a bike with training wheels. As you progress in this game, you will, in time, learn to lose the training wheels, take off the mask, and begin to open with a natural game and express your identity to women and to the world. Does that make sense?
A little bit.
So the idea behind this program today is I'm going to give you certain openers or routines. We call them canned routines, in the can, back pocket openers, that you can use for those 2 to 3 seconds to build the attraction. And then when it's time, when you get in the comfort phase, you're trying to build trust, comfort, connection, you sit down with her, you can take the mask off, let down your guard, be yourself, allow her to do the same, and then you can actually build a real connection. Slide. So, the opening phase, A1. To begin a conversation with a person or a group of people. The word open, as it is used in the community, stems from mystery, who borrowed the term from magicians to use it to refer to a starting performance. In the parlance of a magician, opening a set. Opening is one of the first steps in pickup beyond making eye contact. Opening is usually accomplished by an opener, which is a piece of conversation the PUA uses to get into set. It can be as simple as saying hi, or reciting a memorized set of canned routines.
Get it.
Dominoes.
In pickup, as in life, first impressions are important, so it is a good idea to set the proper frame when first opening a set or a target. What up?
Hey, how's it
Adam?
Going?
Long time, I'm brother.
Interrupting your presentation.
Come on in. There's not much chair left.
Here, oh, I got one.
Thanks.
I'm going right to the target. Thank you. Thank you, Michelle.
You're welcome.
Slide.
It's not his first class.
So an opener. Openers are what PUAs use to get conversation started with the woman they're interested in. PUA openers can range from a simple hello to elaborate stories that have been crafted to get their target interested in them. An opener is simply used to begin the conversation. A lot of guys, they get this concept and they learn an opener. And most of these openers are scripted so that they're a few paragraphs long, maybe even a few minutes long. The idea is to just use it to spark the conversation, and then you want to snip and stack to your next routine. If you stay on the opener too long, it becomes boring. Have you guys ever done like the, what do you ever walk up to a girl and you use the opener like, do you guys believe in drunk I love yous? And this opener is like 5 minutes long. And
drunk, it's a comedy routine.
Yeah. So when you come in,
no, but I'd like to learn that one.
Yeah, it's good, and it'll work, and they'll get engaged. But when you do the whole opener, they're gonna lose interest. So you want to cut it at one point, and then stack your next routine. All right, next slide. Types of openers. I'm gonna give you a definition on each one of these. Canned opener. We're gonna discuss a few of those today. I'm gonna give you a lot of direct and indirect. A canned opener, like I said before, is a routine that's already memorized, a scripted pattern. You can even keep it on a cheat sheet in your back pocket if you want. So when you're going into the venue, you ever hear that, you feel that moment? There's this perfect, beautiful girl right here. And your buddy's just managed to help you get the balls enough to push you, just go talk to her. You're like, what am I going to say? What am I going to say? What am I going to say? I got to think of the magic line that's going to get her panties wet and make her lights light up and want to sex me right now. Hi.
You think the same thing.
I like the music in here. Yeah. I like your shoes. So we all have that problem, right? Comes up from time to time. So instead of that, we already have scripted routines that I'm going to give you tonight. So you can have them on your autopilot response. So when you see your target, you can immediately go and, hey, guys, get this. I have a quick question. I got to get back to my friends. Okay, slide. Oh, no, hold it. This is a long slide. Okay, a direct opener. A direct opener is an opener that's instantly telegraphing interest. If I walk up, I'm like, you are smoking hot. Want to hang out? I'm instantly kind of giving all my cards. Right away, she knows what I want. The game is over. I already given her the power. Direct will work if she's already attracted to you. Let's say I was up on stage doing karaoke, and she's like, oh, God, this guy's hot. He's doing it. And then I have my my wing come in. Yeah, that's my buddy up there. This guy's awesome. He, you know, owns this club and blah. And now she's already like, look, this guy's hot. So if I actually come up to her at that point and I telegraph some interest, she's going to be responsive. She's probably going to buy me a drink. We're going to do a lot of, I'm going to give you some canned direct ones that'll help you out. Indirect is exactly the opposite. Indirect is when I'm not telegraphing any interest. I'm playing coy, I'm playing hard to get, or I'm acting like I'm just leaving. Or maybe I'm just chatting her up just for shits and giggles. I might come in and I mingle with my friends and I see you guys and I'm like, well, what do you guys think of this? What do you guys think of the 49ers or the Cowboys? Oh. I'm not telegraphing any interest, right? But the conversation's starting now. Digital openers. Email. This is where I can go on Plenty of Fish, Match.com, eHarmony, and I can telegraph some kind of interest to the girl, but I'm not actually face-to-face. I get a little box with subject matter, and I get the email line. We're not really going to go into this. The online game is like a whole other topic, but if you guys...
Sorry, you're just...
Dude, you're working on it.
Yeah. Sorry, you heard a goat on me. It's easy. Done.
Do you got dollar bills?
I was about to say.
Sorry, the next one's not coming off.
So, you guys ever do any online game?
Never.
Yeah.
Not since high school.
A little bit.
A little bit? Have you noticed anything, like any kind of patterns?
So, it's kind of random what I've noticed. It likes one thing that works on one, doesn't work on another, but realistically, when I do it, it's usually just act more cavemanish and just don't care.
A lot of guys like, if you guys ever do any online game, the way you get really good is actually make a female avatar profile and just watch the kind of responses the guys get. Mm-hmm. You always see subject matter.
Recon.
Hi. Yeah. Box. Wow, you're hot. Yep. Now, if she goes on vacation for a week and comes back and checks her email, she'll have 300 of this 90%. Identical message. Yeah. She's going to scroll down. She's never even going to see it. So, if you guys want to know some